गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ आवर मैथ्स लेक्चर्स एंड द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इन फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड इज नंबर्स एंड न्यूमरेशन. सो इन दिस टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द फाइव डिजिट एंड सिक्स डिजिट नंबर्स. सो ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट देयर प्लेस वैल्यूज एंड फेस वैल्यूज. वी आर गोइंग टू सी द इंडियन नंबर सिस्टम as well as the international number system. But before beginning to learn all these things, the exercise 1 in this chapter is in the form of a revision of all that we have studied in our last class, that is in standard 3rd. So first we will solve the exercise 1 to have a quick revision of all these things, and then we will start learning with the new points or new syllabus. So exercise 1 is to be solved today. Here I have solved two examples from some questions of the exercise 1. I will be explaining it to you and then I will be giving you the homework on the same pattern. So the first question in exercise 1 is, some digits are given to you and you are expected to write them in words. You have to write their spellings of those digits. That is, you have to write them in words. So suppose the first number given to you is this, that is 3849. It is a 4-digit number. And we have learned about the place values of 4-digit numbers. 9 is in 1's place, 4 is in 10's place, 8 is in 100's place, while 3 is in 1000's place. So how are we going to write it? We are going to write it 3849. Okay. The next example here is 7777. Here in 1's place, 10's place, 100's place and 1000's place, all the place values we have the digit 7. We can write it in the form 7777. When we speak about the place values, we go from right to left. 1's, 10's, 100's, 1000's. But when we are writing the names, when we are writing the digits in words, we go from left to right. First we write the greater place value, that is we begin from 7000, then 700, then 70 and 7. So this was the first question, or you can say the first pattern of revision. Digits will be given to you and you have to write them in words. You have to write their spellings. The second question is also based on this type only, but there is just a change. What is given? The numbers are given to you in words and you are expected to write them in numbers. So for you the question will be 3849. Write these words into numeral forms. Write it in number forms. So I have not written a separate pattern for it. You can understand it between these two examples. Next type of question in the exercise is about the expanded form. Write in expanded form. So what is done? A digit is given to you like 6827. We read it 6827, since it is a 4-digit number. You are given this number and you are asked to write it in expanded form. What is expanded form now? So you have to write the place values of each numbers in the form of addition. So the place value of 6, it is in thousands. So the place value of 6 becomes 6000. Here I have written 6000. Next is the place value of 8. 8 is in hundreds place. So the place value of 8 becomes 800. I have written 800 here. Then the digit 2. 2 is in tens place. And so we have to write the place value of 2, which is 20 and 7 is in 1's place. So its place value and its value remains the same, that is 7. So 7. 6000 plus 800 plus 20 plus 7. So also you can see the second example, which is 8105. So how do we write this? First we will write the place value of 8, that is 1000. So 8000. Next is 1. The place value, it is in the place of 100. So 100. In the tens place we have 0. And 0 does not have any value, so it remains 0. And the place value of 5, it is in 1's place, so it remains 5. So I have written 8000 plus 100 plus 5. So this is the expanded form. You are also expected to write the short form. This expanded form is given to you and you have to write it in the short form like this. Okay, so there are changes. Here also we have changes. You are given this, you have to write this. Sometimes you are given this, you have to write this. Same is with the expanded form and short form. Sometimes expanded form is given while sometimes short form is given. So you have to do either or. The next is finding the predecessors and successors. Now what are these predecessors and successors? Predecessor means the number before the given number. And successor means the number after the given number. So, to find out predecessor, what is expected? We should subtract 1 from the given number. And if we are to find out the successor, we can add 1 to the given number. So, for example, here the number given is 2000. If we are expected to write the predecessor, then we have to subtract 1 from the given number. The given number is 2000, and if we subtract 1 from the given number, the given number is 2000 and we will subtract 1, so 0 minus 1 not possible. So what we will do, we will take a carry on from here. Here also we don't have, so we will take from here, and here from here we have taken already here, so here it becomes 9, here again it becomes 9. And from here we have taken, so it becomes 1. From this 10, we minus 1, we get 9. Also this 9 comes as it is, this 9 comes as it is, and this 1 comes down. So the predecessor is 1999. And successor, what is to be done? If we want to find out the successor, we have to add 1. So 0 plus 1 becomes 1. 0000, and this 2 comes as it is. So 2001, the successor will become 2001. This is the same case with this number also. You can minus, you can subtract 1, you will get predecessor, and if you add 1, you will get the successor. Okay, so the next is finding the place value. So what is finding the place value? In our earlier examples, we saw what is finding the place value, or we talked about the place values of each digit when we were writing the expanded form. So here we have not to do anything else, but we have to just find the place values. So 4 digit numbers are given to you, that is 4367. So the under, we have to find out the value of this underlined number. So when we are talking about the place value, we come from right to left. So the first number at the right is 7, it is in 1's place, and this 6 is in 10's place. So when we are talking about the place values, what we do, it is in 1's place, then we multiply it with 1 only. So 1's place, multiply with 1. When the digit is in 10's place, multiply it with 10. When it is in hundreds place, multiply it with 100. When it is in thousands place, multiply it with 1000. So now the digit is in tens place, so we should multiply it with 10. So 6 into 10 becomes 60. So what is the place value of 6? It is 60. Okay. Similarly, we can solve the second question, that is 1438. Now the underlined digit is 4, and this 4 comes in ones, tens and hundreds place. So we have to multiply this 4 with 100. 4 into 100 becomes 400. So the place value of 4 is 400. In the exercise, some more examples are there. You can solve it accordingly. And the next question is, use correct sign. So the signs given here are smaller than, greater than and equal to. So you have to make use of these three signs to solve these examples. So the numbers given here, you can see the first number is 2014 and the second is 1260. Now you have to compare both these numbers and find out which is the smaller one and which is the greater one. So to find out which is the greater and the smaller, what we do, we first see the highest place. So here both the numbers are 4 digit numbers, so we have to see the thousands place here. In this number you can see 2 is in the thousands place, and in this digit we can see 1 is in the thousands place. So 2 is greater than 1, and that is why this number will be greater than the second number. And if the first number is greater, then we use this sign. So 2014 is greater than 1260. So also you can see the second example, 8357, and on the other side we have 8375. So all the four digits in this second example are similar, but there are some changes in their places. So here you can see, first we will see the thousands place, 8 and 8, both are same. Then we will see for the hundreds place, 3 and 3, both are similar too. Next we will see the tens place, here we have 5 and here we have 7. So change in the places. So this 5 is smaller than this 7. So what can we tell? We can say that 8375 is greater than 8357. Since this number, first number is smaller, smaller arrow will come towards the smaller number and this greater arrow will go towards the greater number. Okay, so now see the third example, that is 6825, and on the other side we have 6825. So both the numbers are same, their place values are same. It means that both these numbers are equal, and so we will make use of the equal sign. So these were the examples. Also there have been asked in exercise number 1 about the ascending order and descending order. You all are very familiar with the ascending order and descending order. Ascending order means from smaller number to greater number, and descending order means from greater number to smaller number. So also there are other examples which are easier, like as I told you, your place value. There are questions like find out the predecessor of some number, find out the successor of some number. So such type of easy questions are also asked in the exercise number 1. Now the homework for you today is to solve the entire exercise 1 in your maths notebook. Once you solve the exercise, you will get revised with the syllabus of your earlier class, that is 3rd standard, and then it will be easier for you to understand the new syllabus of 4th standard. And so the first exercise itself is given on the basis of revision. So all of you are going to solve the exercise 1, and tomorrow we will begin with the new points or the Indian number system, international number system and many more other things from the first topic, that is numbers and numeration. So these were some examples from the exercise 1. You are going to solve the entire exercise.